So here we got Jablan's eye, but as you can see, they do have longest eyelashes we ever seen. But the eyelashes are also playing a huge role to protect this, I mean, the sun direct into the eye, and also to protect all the falling objects, you know, not to get into the ear, I mean, into the eye. So it's very important that they should have the eyelashes. But I guess that's what every woman is dying for, right?
Yeah. Although Booby still has the best.
Booby has, yeah, the longest eyelashes ever.
So you can see the top eyelashes are also much longer than the bottom ones. Because they're closing over.
Yes, and you can see there's a lot of mud, you know, in those eyelashes, which means, I mean, they were like playing a huge role, like protecting the mud not to enter the eye. So it's a very, very fascinating feature on elephant. You know how it plays a huge role in elephant day life.
So showing you where elephants do have hair. We've got on the eye. Then we also have on the ear. Look at all those hair. And then we have on the whole body. Even on the tip of the, you can see that. On the tip of the ears. And then the bodies.
On the trunk.
And look at on the trunk.
Ones on the trunk, they are more likely, they are more like whiskers. Gives the elephant the sensation and, I mean, the feel. When you touch them, they know you are touching them because of the whiskers. It sends all the, you know, the signals into the navy, and then they know that you are touching them. So touching is also part of their communication. It's very important. So us as carers, the more you touch an elephant, the more they communicate with your body, the more they understand that you are calm, you are not there for, you know, causing trouble. So we call it tactile. It is very important mechanism of communication among themselves too.
You see, they even have hair over there. That's like a moustache nearly, because it goes.
Yes, right underneath his, you know, more like on the chin there. Yeah. So the entire body of an elephant contains the hairs, more likely for sensation, that's all. Every part of it, you see, but from a distance it's invisible.
You can even see on the elmboog, what do you call this in English?
Elbow.
On the elbow, yeah. Even if it's harsh, they do have, you can see them.
Yeah, you can see it.
Oh, there you see it better. Yeah. See, some of them are longer and shorter than others. These are actually soft ones. The hairy bits and pieces. Yeah, I'll also take some of Ganisa because she's got long, long hair. You can see on his legs there.
Almost
hind legs.
Easy. Good boy.
There at the top. You can see that. So this is a tail here. You can see he flaps it just like that.
Keeping all the flies away from him. So that's one of the major issues for the tail hairs, is to keep other flies or, you know, the bugs away from the entire body. So where he can't reach in front there, he actually uses the trunk. So he can stretch the trunk to a point where he can, you know, chase all the flies, or maybe, you know, pick up the sand and throw the sand underneath. But at the back here, you can't do that. That's where he needs the tail. And also the tail is important when it comes to balancing, when they're running or walking or whatever. It also maintains elephant balancing so that they have enough balance to run or, you know, turning or twisting. So it is quite important. So the hairs are very long, which is looks quite beautiful. unlike other animals, the hares are on more likely, you know, southern side and northern side of the tail, but the other party is quite plain, as you can see. It's not like other animals where the whole tail is covered. This is quite beautiful. If you take a look at it,
it actually has nearly like a flat side. Okay, so this part, it doesn't, it's very sensitive. Steady, yeah. He thinks I'm also a fly, but you can see that the hair. Maybe I'm irritating him like a fly now because I'm all over his tail, as you can see that.
Steady, boy.
And then he's got the flat side. So that is how it's very interesting how it's distributed. One side without any hair. Then we go up. Can actually see some hair again. He's got hairy legs. He's clearly not shaving.
Hey, Jabu.
We had Popo, and that's Booby, feeding close to Kanisa. Just on a different note, it's actually interesting to look at this tree. So this tree, you can see, was pushed down. Okay. But it's level over here. Then it goes up and it's actually growing at all different parts. So it's actually, you can see how it's growing out, all of that. So although this tree's been pushed over, nearly destroyed by the elephants, it's growing back, and actually in a bigger, better way, if that makes sense. A nice, fresh leaves.
Easy.
Places.
Easy, Kumbula. Easy. Easy.
Oh my goodness.